Assalamualaikum. This is War Media After News on the War Radio. We present our weekly review. Listen with your eyes. The headlines. Southwest chief slams governor's orders to march with placards on National Day celebrations. Defense Counsel of Sisiku Ayoktabe and Co. announced boycott of all proceeding hearings. Sisiku Ayoktabe allegedly declared comeback. United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights was in Cameroon. Bilingualism Commission dispel rumor on the ban in the use of Anglophone and Francophone. MRC to boycott 20th May celebration. Coming up next, the reviews. The Southwest Chiefs Conference have condemned the statement made by Southwest Governor Bernard Okalabilai, ordering the Boya Chiefs to march past the grandstand on the 20th of May with placards bearing the names of their villages while their subjects follow behind. Referring to the governor's speech as appalling, inappropriate, demeaning, and threatening, the Southwest Chiefs Conference categorically condemned the manner by which the governor of the Southwest region reminded them of their usual civic duties, which they have always performed so diligently without being ordered by whosoever. While solemnly cautioning the peaceful and law-abiding population of the Southwest region to remain calm in the face of the governor's provocative statements, they, however, refused to yield to the governor's orders because, as natural leaders, their native laws and customs do not permit them to march past the grandstand during public ceremonies. The communique, signed on Tuesday, the 30th of April 2019, by the President of the Southwest Chiefs Conference, His Majesty Chief Mafani Njie Martin, came up 5 days after, that is on Thursday, the 25th of April 2019, where, as seen in a video that went viral, the governor of the Southwest region, Bernard Okalabilai, while chairing the first preparatory meeting ahead of the celebrations marking the 47th edition of the National Day to be celebrated on Monday, May 20th, 2019, threatened to dethrone and replace chiefs of Boya who failed to march past the grandstand on the 20th of May with their subjects after 30 days.
The 20th May, this day, all the chiefs will march with a pancart indicating their village and their population follow behind. If that is not the case, it means those chiefs don't exist. If you fail to do what I'm instructing, you will see 30 days after the consequences of that disobedience.
Meanwhile, lawyers defending Sisiku Ayoktabe and other leaders of the Ambazonian movement have announced that all hearings before the military tribunal will be boycotted starting Monday, April 29, 2019. The office of the chairman of the media and communications for the defense team of Sisiku Ayok and others said in a press statement that court appearances shall only resume before the military tribunal after their appeal pending before the appeal court of the central region shall be determined by the jurisdiction. The lawyer said the move is backed by law, which states the lower court obligatorily suspends all other business and proceedings once an interlocutory appeal is filed. Sisiku Ayoktabe and other Ambazonian leaders were due to appear at the military court on Monday in Yaounde. The leaders have been persecuted in the military court on charges of acts of terrorism, advocating terrorism, cessation, civil war, and revolution vis-a-vis the prevailing Cameroon-Ambazonian war in the two English-speaking regions of Cameroon. The tension in court between the new judge, Mise Njone, who took over Colonel Mem Michel, left one of the suspects, Barrister Iyambe Elias, to collapse in the Friday 29th March session, forcing the judge to postpone to Monday the 8th of April 2019. The lead lawyer said they appealed against a ruling that gave the military court jurisdiction to try their clients. The military court don't have any rights to try our clients, he said, adding that during the last hearing on Monday, April 8, they boycotted for same reason before it was adjourned to Monday, April 29, 2019. The appeal court in Yaounde is yet to decide on the habeas corpus case filed by the defense lawyers for the release of the Ambazonian leaders. Meanwhile, Sisiku Ayoktabe allegedly declared comeback on the social media. Sisiku Ayok Julius allegedly sent an unexpected message on Thursday the 2nd of May from the Kundinge Central Prison that was groundbreaking to the Ambazonian revolutionary struggle. Regretting the losses, infighting and mismanagement, while referring to the acting government that took over the interim government as caretaker government, the incarcerated interim president of the Ambazonian struggle wrote, I hereby declare and direct that the caretaker cabinet is forthwith dissolved and that the cabinet as was in office on January 5th, 2018, when myself and part of the leadership were abducted, be restituted, restored, and reactivated. Most activists and Ambalanders in the liberation struggle don't believe this is coming from Sisiku himself and call it fake. Few hours after the statement, Samuel Sako passively referred to the document as distraction via his Facebook page. He wrote, fellow Ambazonians, your interim government and your acting president can only get stronger. We have come past the age of distractions that divides our peoples further and steal our revolution. We have a bigger task ahead. We need to focus on collectively rendering 20th May colonial celebration a new event in our nation. I therefore call on all to stay calm, country first, politics second. A few hours later, another document still allegedly signed by Sisiku, disclaiming the first document while calling on Ambazonians to stay loyal to the interim government and focus to the liberation struggle, popped on the social media. The United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights was in Cameroon. The President of the Republic, His Excellency Paul Biya, met with Michelle Bachelet, the United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights, at the Unity Palace on 3 May 2019. The UN scribe and former President of the Republic of Chile, 2006 to 2010 and 2014 to 2018, was in Cameroon for a four-day working visit upon the invitation of the head of state. Speaking to journalists after the audience, Her Excellency Michelle Bachelet revealed that she had a good conversation with President Paul Biya. I had a meeting with the president on all the different situations the country is still facing on peace and security, development, and human rights, she said. The UN diplomat added that their discussion was hinged on how the Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights can support government efforts in the continuous respect, promotion, and protection of human rights. President Paul Biya decorated Her Excellency Michelle Bachelet with the Medal of Grand Office of the National Order of Valor. Since her arrival on the 1st of May 2019, Michelle Bachelet has held separate talks with the Prime Minister, Head of Government, and some members of government, including the Minister of State, the Minister of Justice and Keeper of the Seals, the Minister of External Relations, the Minister of Territorial Administration, the Minister Delegate at the Presidency in Charge of Defense, the Minister of Secondary Education, and the Minister of Women Empowerment and the Family. Meanwhile, Bilingualism Commission dispelled rumor on the ban in the use of Anglophone and Francophone. After a spate of criticisms, the National Commission for Bilingualism and Multiculturalism finally clears the air through a release signed on Friday, the 3rd of May 2019 by Peter Mafane Mosonge. Bilingualism Commission has dispelled rumors of having proposed the ban in the use of the words Anglophone and Francophone in Cameroon. He notes that the commission he heads organized a colloquium on April 24th and 25th, 2019 at Hotel Montfebe, Yaoundé, under the theme Multiculturalism at the Crossroads Between Traditions and Modernity. It was simply one of the recommendations made by 62 university dons who attended the colloquium. MRC to boycott 20 May celebration. The Cameroon Renaissance Movement Party of Maurice Kamto, through a release signed by Noah Roger Justin, Deputy Secretary General of the party, announced to boycott activities marking the celebrations of National Day on the 20th of May 2019. That is what we gathered for you this week. Thanks for listening. Until next time, I am Kingsley Mangula for the War Media Outlet.